administration said those tariffs were in response to complaints that Beijing steals or pressures foreign companies to hand over technology. Lead times and disappointing economic reports weighing down the markets. Manufacturing activity slowed across the country last month. The Institute for Supply Management's manufacturing index fell 1.3 in March. That was a bigger decline than economists expected. Still a strong reading, though, because any number above 50 indicates expansion in the manufacturing sector. Meantime, construction spending rose in February, according to the latest figures from the Commerce Department, but that increase was less than expected. Construction spending ticked up just 0.1%. Analysts blame a steep drop-off in spending on public construction projects. It tumbled 2.1%. That's Money on One. I'm Matt McClure.
Well, a viral campaign that began in the United Kingdom has some officials and advocacy groups here fearing for the safety of Muslims. New York One's Lindsay Tuchman has the story.
This letter was sent to many homes in Britain. It is now circulating on social media here. It declares April 3rd Punish a Muslim Day and encourages people in hateful detail to verbally and physically assault Muslims, offering more points for more violent acts.
My immediate reaction was that of disgust. And after that, it was action.
Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams joined with representatives of the NYPD's Muslim Officer Society and other community groups to serve notice that hate will not be tolerated.
This letter is despicable. This letter has the energy of someone who wants to do harm. Let's embrace the diversity that this city has to offer. This is a strong message that it is unacceptable and won't be tolerated. Any concept of attempting to harm a person because of their religious beliefs.
The NYPD's Intelligence Bureau says there's no evidence of the...
Recovered the object and say it appears to be a pipe with a knob on it. They say they also have video evidence of the encounter, and he was not an emotionally disturbed person. The Queens man accused of killing his three-year-old stepdaughter is arraigned. Mark Jenkins is charged with second-degree murder and assault in the death of Bella Edwards. The 32-year-old has a lengthy criminal record.
At the time, we were able to arrest him in the 112 precinct, on which he did a substantial amount of jail time before he came out, and then he was with another girl, and he took up with this girl right here.
Bella Edwards was found unconscious with blunt force trauma to her stomach in her home on Beach 105th Street in the Rockaways Monday night. Police sources say her body also showed signs of sexual abuse. The Administration for Children's Services says it has no records of any previous abuse. Jenkins faces up to 25 years to life in prison if convicted. Police are investigating a murder-suicide on the Upper East Side. Police responded to an apartment building on East 93rd Street Wednesday afternoon. When they arrived, they found...